say it again, rejoice. You may recognize that from Paul's letter to the Philippians. Of course, equally applies to us today, and I'm sure Gary will have a interesting lesson on rejoice today. I'm looking forward to it. Let's take a moment and go to our Father in prayer. Would you pray with me, please? Father, we're so thankful we can meet in this place. We can meet together with our family. This place provides a good place for visitors to come and worship with us, to worship you and your Son. And Father, help us in our worship, in our singing. Let us lift up our voices and praise you, praise Jesus. And may we let the Spirit guide us and give us understanding, and give us comfort. Father, this time of year can be filled with so many emotions. We meet up with our family members and friends, and we enjoy our time together, but yet we often reflect on family and friends who have departed from us. Help us with that. Help us, Father, to maintain our joy, and as Paul encouraged the Philippians, to rejoice. Father, be with us in our world today as we see horrible conflicts and rising tension. We see war. Help us understand and remember you are in control. Be with our country, be with world leaders, and give them wisdom to make the right decisions. Help us not to be anxious, but trust wholly in you, that you, in our trust, will deliver us. Even though we may not fully understand all the events that are unfolding and the steps being taken, give us that faith that you will get us through it. And Father, I want to thank you for the men who will be leading our worship today. May we praise you in Jesus, and in all these things we ask through his name. Amen.